Minister, there's something rotten at the core of the Seanad. And what is rotten at the core of the Seanad is the way that the Seanad is elected. It is, in my view, an elitist. It's an apartheid system. It's a system that belongs to a different era and doesn't belong to modern Ireland. And what we're trying to do here, and I was taken aback when I seen this piece of legislation, given the promises we've had for government for real Seanad reform, and we use this word Seanad reform, but what does it really mean? Because we can reform the Seanad, and let's remember, you know, Fianna Fáil, Fine Gael, Labour, the Independents signed up to an all-party report on Seanad reform at the last Seanad term. What did that reform mean? Because people are demanding reform, but what does the reform actually mean? The recommendations were to increase the number of senators and to increase the number of Taoiseach appointees. Now, there was other positive things, but that's the type of reform that I definitely don't want. We do need serious reform here, and what we have in this legislation is conferring on a group of councillors, and I have nothing against Lama and the huge work that they've done, the very important work they've done representing councillors across the state, but to give that body that represents councillors more power in relation to the election of the Seanad. Not only do they have already the majority, the vast majority of power as to determine who is actually going to sit in these seats, but now we want to give them the power actually to nominate who will be the people that can go before the electorate, their electorate, in relation to getting elected into the Seanad. So it is completely and utterly in the opposite direction of where I want to see the Seanad go. The Seanad should be abolished, because I really believe that there is no political will to grasp the bull by the horns and take this issue on. Since the foundation of the state, we've been seeing report after report about Seanad reform, which has never been lived up to. We've seen a referendum which has never been implemented by government. And we now have statements coming out which I genuinely think are, you know, and I think that it adds to the mistrust in politics. When you have the second largest party in this state saying that they're going to abolish the Seanad, and then the party comes in and actually extends the franchise of the nominating bodies to a group of elected members. It is, you know, it is issues like that there that causes deep mistrust with the Irish public in relation to policies. We need honest politics, and I honestly believe that this direction, this bill, is the wrong direction that the Seanad should go in. We need to get to the core of how the Seanad is elected, to bring democracy to the Seanad by allowing all the people, all citizens of Ireland, whether they live here or not, to vote in elections. And I agree with Senator Hannigan, it's something we've been arguing for long, that people of the age of 16 and over should be able to vote in Seanad elections. They should be able to do so by registering with their embassies, or if they're abroad, or registering here. We should also make sure that the duplication that currently exists in the Seanad does not exist. Because look, in reality, is there a chance, really, outside of the independent benches, is there a chance that anyone of those elected by the sectoral panels could be truly independent? The reality is it's not, because politicians have made the laws that are conferred to them under the Constitution, have made the laws and designed that the electorate of the Seanad will be elected by elected politicians, which is dominated by the political parties. And the system is completely and utterly flawed. And this year, this type of legislation is taking us down that road of strengthening the inequality, strengthening the lack of democracy that is at the core of the Seanad, that makes the Seanad the reason that there is distaste in the public out there for the Seanad is because of the duplication of work between the Dáil and the Seanad, but also the fundamental lack of democracy, the fact that it is elitist, the fact that, you know, when I was a councillor, I was getting ties being sent to me by senators and boxes of chocolates and calendars and this and that and the other. And that is happening today. Senators are sending councillors of my parties and other DVDs of this and DVDs of that and, you know, scarves and whatnot. And it is just completely ridiculous, because senators know that if you keep 100 councillors happy, you will have a job for life. And it's a good job, because you'll get €70,000, you'll get a good pension, you'll get parking out the front for the rest of your life, whether you're in the Seanad or not. And in reality, you don't have to represent a constituency, because the senators don't have a constituency. And that is why there's so much distaste with the public. So I do agree with your sentiments. Piecemeal change is not what we need. It is fundamental, radical change that will restructure the Seanad, if it's to be restructured, if the political will is there, to make it a modern institution that can serve the needs of Ireland in the 21st century. I disbelieve that that is there within the major political parties in this state, and that's why I believe that the Shannon should be abolished. But I seriously question the sincerity of the Fine Gael party on this issue, given the legislation that they've put forward. And I have no doubt that their party leader, who made such an issue of this here, has endorsed this legislation.
Mr. Brady.